Blackstone Publishing presents Cat Got Your Diamonds, a Kitty Couture Mystery by Julie Chase. This book is read by Brittany Pressley. Chapter 1. Furry Godmother's Secret to Stunning Shih Tzu Tutus. More glitter. I squinted through my freshly cleaned shop window at a lively group of women snapping selfies with the Magazine Street sign in front of a New Orleans police car and broken-in storefront. Humidity had twisted their hair to Albert Einstein proportions. An officer, standing several feet away, looked as confused as the jewelry shop owner sweeping broken glass. Crime wasn't usually a problem in the Garden District, but this was the second jewelry heist in a week. The whole conundrum made me glad I owned a pet boutique. There wasn't much of a black market for animal couture, and my baked goods had an expiration date. Thieves aside, it was a beautiful New Orleans day. 97 with a real feel of 113. Home sweet home. Hard to believe I'd ever left. Even harder to believe that somewhere beyond the sprawling mansions and mighty Mississippi was my cheating ex-fiancé and our tabby Penelope. Pearl Niedermeyer was in front of me yammering away. Lacy.
Hello, Lacy Crocker, are you listening to me?
Yes, ma'am. I smiled at the woman who taught me ballet for 3 months as a child. Every word. My mother had put me in every form of dance and pageantry for years, before she accepted the painful truth. I was my father's daughter, made more for observation than participation. I also shared Dad's love of animals and art, which had led me to opening Furry Godmother, a custom pet boutique and organic, animal-friendly bakery. My degree in fashion design was finally paying off. My favorite ensembles were captured on film and hung around the room in collages of antique, gilded frames. Animals had been my life's passion for as long as I could remember. Who knew that one day I'd be making custom creations for a literal catwalk? Below the photographs, white oak shelves lined three walls, heavy laden with products, mixes, and baking supplies. The turtles and aquarium took residence on the fourth, a nice touch for atmosphere and entertaining children. Wide shop windows welcomed ample light from Magazine Street and invited shoppers inside for a peek or sample. A row of white mini chandeliers hung from the ceiling, classing up the joint. My pink and green color scheme was adorable, with punches of yellow for zip. Mrs. Niedermeyer's bangle bracelets jangled as she paced.
Those fat cats are making a big entrance at the gala. They're building custom carriages. I can't compete with custom carriages, so our costumes need to pack a punch.
I rubbed my palms together and pulled myself away from the window. Your dancers need something spectacular.
Exactly.
Images exploded in my mind like movie theater popcorn. Shiny, dazzling popcorn. I lifted a finger.
I have an idea.
I opened the drawer behind the counter where I kept notepads, cardstock, and a rainbow of sticky notes. I snagged my favorite pink sketch pad and smiled.
The costumes I create for your Shih Tzus will be so stunning, every dance coach on the East Coast will want your name.
I grabbed a pencil and scribbled notes.
I'll start with silver sequin jackets.
Mrs. Niedermeyer shook her head and pressed her lips tight.
No jackets. The darlings can't perform properly with their legs all wrapped in sequins. Remember practicality.
It's not a photo shoot, darling. This is the jazz festival we're talking about. We need to make a real impression at the Animal Elegance Gala. The judges must be awed. I snickered, dancing my pencil over the paper, sketching lines and curves where crinoline and glitter would meet in sheer pageant perfection. People do think I'm a little odd. She moved closer and set her stupendously bedazzled flip phone on the counter.
I said odd, not odd.
Her frown said she didn't necessarily disagree with my being odd. Sometimes I forgot I was the only one who thought wordplay was hilarious. I inhaled deeply and leaned my elbows onto the counter. My long, pale blonde ringlets swung around my arms.
What do you think of something like this?
She scrutinized my work. Her lips twitched, but she shut the smile down quick and tight.
I need seven. Make them spectacular. No jackets. Don't forget, this is your time to shine too, dear.
A few media mentions from an event of this caliber, and you can put your name...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.